the piece that we included in this little training guide for piccolo was obviously the Stars and Stripes Forever. John Philip Sousa. The solo at the end where they all stand up. Not fun for a lot of piccolo players. It's actually quite difficult. We wanted to include that in the book, and we wanted to include ways to make that easier to play, because there are definitely some alternate fingerings for the trills especially, that, and for some of the longer held notes, that would help keep the pitch where it should be, so you don't have a bunch of screeching piccolos all playing out of tune, and of course make it easier for you technically. I took some time to research how this piece came to be. Sousa lost his manager. He tragically passed, and Sousa was on a boat and basically was mourning this person's death all the way back to America, and was writing this piece in his head as he walked the decks of the boat. It was interesting. He wanted to have a motive that would be reminiscent of the South, and a motive that would be reminiscent of the North. He wanted to kind of help America come together and, you know, be one. And so he wanted this to be a piece that everyone could look at and say, I'm an American, and this represents America for me. When it first was played, it actually didn't have that effect at first. And for the rest, you're going to have to read the book, because we're putting a little paragraph in. It's really interesting how this piece became the kind of iconic work that it is today. So, but for those long-suffering piccolo players, and that's everybody from 100 down to 10, we're going to have a way in the book to make it much easier for you to play this really famous solo. People fear it, I think, more than they should. It doesn't have to be as hard as it is. I do think just in general, having it in A-flat major, it's just hard. But it's not impossible. Check out all the tips and tricks. We'll have it in there for you.